I am completely devastated. Like, you have no idea. I already cried my heart out and I'm feeling it again. And why does Lainey Taylor does this to me? Like, I can't understand. And for those of you that were suddenly cut off of the vlog of last week, because let's face it was a very completely week to film, so welcome to the last week of the Owls readathon. I am almost finishing Strange the Dreamer, and I don't want to spoil anyone, but the way that this is going, I just want to crawl in a hole and be there safe to cry all of my tears. Like, I'm getting emotional again. This is destroying me. Like, I am 10 pages away from the end and I am destroyed. Just destroyed. I haven't even combed my hair today. Like, I woke up, I decided to read a little bit before going to the gym, and goodness me, I am destroyed. And I am going to read the last 10 pages while I eat my toast before going to the gym, and I know I'm going to feel really bad. But I have to, and I just love how Lainey Taylor does this. I am never waiting for what she's gonna do. I never know what's going to happen. Like, there were some things that I was pretty sure that were going to happen, but then again, I didn't know if they were going to happen. But oh my God, is this book beautiful? I can't. I want to finish it and start reading it again. And oh my God. I'm just gonna read the last 10 pages, and then when I am better, I will give you an update on the things. So, I don't know if I have shown you the book. Like, my cover is different from others. Like, yeah, my cover is like this, which I think it's the new covers, new paperback editions. It's fairly blue. My only problem is that it doesn't have the original moth in the cover. And I love the original moth, but I really enjoy this cover as well. And let's face it, what matters is what's on the inside, which is one of the most perfect books I've ever read. Like, no exaggeration. And just wow. I mean, is this shit heavy? But well, I'm gonna finish this and then I will update you in a better condition, I hope. So, if you might have guessed by my current face and, my hair. I have gone to the gym after I talked with you guys, and I haven't showered yet because I wanted to just update you because I got the feeling that I won't be able to do it throughout the afternoon because I've got my report to fill. So, Strange the Dreamer, everybody. Like, I get tears in my eyes every time I think about that ending and every time I think about everything that happened in that story. Like, genuinely, I don't want to cry, and I think it's stupid that I'm crying about this, but the writing was just so beautiful, and the plot was just amazing, and it was beautiful. It was beautiful. So, I concluded Strange the Dreamer today, and we are at the 24th of April, Tuesday. So, I finished my potions exam. And I'm very happy about that because I definitely think that I would have potions if I went to Harry Potter world, and I would love to just continue doing potions throughout the years. So I think it's a good owl to have finished, and it fitted like a glove. All the alchemy stuff and all the beautiful stuff, and oh my God, it was beautiful. I am thinking about doing a separate review about it, but I can't talk about it right now because it's still too fresh on myself. And I know that the only thing that I was going to do was just say I love it, go read it, and that's not why you watch reviews. You watch reviews to have critical content, even if it is good critical content, because I really don't think that there's anything wrong with this book. Like, I can't see anything wrong with this book, but even positive criticism is criticism, so is nice. And I just have to say that I cannot wait. Like, oh my God, I'm genuinely crying, everyone. It's very difficult for me to speak about this, but I can genuinely say that I can't wait for Muse of Nightmares, like for real. And the fact that I know that is only coming in October, it is slicing me up because at the same time, I know that's already coming in October, so I don't have a lot of time to wait as those that read it when Strange Dreamer came out. But at the same time, October is so far away, like we're in April. It's like 6 months until October. No. May, June, July, August, September. Yeah, it's 6 months, give or take. And I don't know if it's going to come out at the beginning of the month or if it's going to come out at the end of the month. Like, I have no idea, but I have to buy it. And I'm getting concerned because I have seen the cover, and the cover is beautiful, but it only fits with the original Strange Dreamer cover, which I don't have because I have the paperback hotter edition. Which, now that I think of it, all of my Lainey Taylor books are of the hotter paperback edition. But I don't know if the Muse of Nightmares will just come out in hardback, or it's already coming out in this paperback edition, or if it's coming out in another paperback edition, because let's face it, I want my books to match. But I will think about that when I have to think about that. So, yeah, I really love the story. I found the characters really amazing and so engrossing, and our main character, Laszlo. He's just, can I keep him like forever? I mean, I am used to every freaking YA story that I read, the guy being that unreachable guy that has traumas in his past and is just this angry dude, and the girl just going after him and stuff, and then you know that he's very sweet and that he loves her very much and whatever. But this guy is so sweet. Like, I spent most of this book wanting to give Laszlo a hug. Like, bro, just come here. I will give you a hug if you want. Because poor Laszlo, it was, oh my God. But he was so special and he was so great and he genuinely just wanted to help every fucker out there. Like, oh, you're in trouble? Let me help you. Oh, you're in trouble? Let me help you. It was like, bro, I appreciate that, but worry about yourself and things that are happening. And when we get to the end, it's just so freaking amazing. And the way he talks is just, I can't. Like, if someone talked with me like that, I would probably marry him. Like, I'm kidding, but he's just so perfect and I love him so much and it pains me to see him suffer and pretty much it pains me to see all the characters suffer because every freaking motherfucker in this book is suffering, which hurts my soul. And I have to say that the supposed, well, I don't believe that this book has villains per se, which is something that I think I'm going to address in my review. But at the same time, you can say that you have like an anti-hero or that you have like someone that is against our main character's pursuit. And oh, sorry, I'm really tired after doing exercise, but yeah, and I haven't eaten, so I have to eat. What was I saying? Ah, but the person that supposedly is going to be our main adversary in the second book, and that it was already kind of a point of interest in this first book. Not even that person, and I'm not going to say sex and or age or anything because I don't want you guys to find out who that person is. Even that person can be considered evil, and I feel sorry for that person, and I want that person to have a hug as well. So I think that Lainey Taylor is great at doing this. Like, she gives you both sides of a thing. And there are no good or evil in those sides. There's just people, different beliefs, different things that happened, and people trying to defend themselves, and it's just beautiful, and people with their own reasons for doing stuff, and it's just great. I just love it, and I think that she's very, very talented. I loved Strange Dreamer. I knew that I was going to like it because I read Daughter of Smoke and Moon trilogy like this, and I loved it. But there were some things that I thought, like, her writing was still beautiful, but in comparison with Strange the Dreamer, I think this one is better. So she's growing as an author and in her stories. Although they similarly have like a same base to it, they're completely different and the themes are different. So I don't know, I really enjoyed it. So I finished that and I'm putting it away because when I look at it, I want to cry. And now I'm going to start City of Bones by Cassandra Clare, which is a complete different sort of feel, or so I'm told, because I've never read a Cassandra Clare book before, but this is supposed to be way more YA-ish and way more not as flourished writing as Lainey Taylor. So everybody knows what City of Bones is. I'm not going to talk to you a lot about it. Just appreciate my edition. This is the Walker Books edition. It is fairly beautiful. I love it. I have all of my Mortal Instruments series in this format. And yeah, I'm gonna start it. This is for Care for Magical Creatures. So currently I have four owls done and I'm going to the fifth one and I propose myself to six. So let's see what we can get from this. I don't know if today I'll do a lot of reading because I have a lot of paper stuff to do. But we will see, and yeah, I want to start reading this. I think it's going to be fairly different from Strange the Dreamer, but I'm happy about it because in a way I need a little cut and I need to just stop thinking about Strange the Dreamer and how perfect it was. So I think this is going to be really good to take me off the drugs. The drugs, you know, I don't consume drugs, okay? So, yeah, I'm just gonna read a little bit before lunch because I don't have time to do anything else before it. And then I will talk to you. And this is getting a very long clip, so apparently we'll have a long vlog again. Sorry about that. Trying to put my camera, my phone, in a place where it doesn't do a lot of noise for you so that you can see me and hear me. So I haven't been vlogging a lot. I vlog a little bit of my experience yesterday when I went to see the Avengers Infinity War, and oh my god, was that a blast. Like, I'm not going to spoil anyone, don't worry, but it was amazing. I actually cried a little bit, and it was everything that I was waiting for. And as someone that didn't grow up on superheroes and just started recently just watch everything and to get ready for this, I feel like it was worth it in a way, like to spend my time watching so many movies and learning so many stories and just trying to be inside of something that I never was inside of. I think it was very worth it to just to watch this movie. Of course, it has its minor flaws. Like, I have some opinions about some stuff that I can say because I can spoil you. But it's nothing compared to the awesomeness and epicness that it actually is. So, yeah. And as for reading, as I already said, I finished Strange the Dreamer. And I started already City of Bones by Cassandra Clare. I'm currently on page 116, 17. So I'm finishing a chapter. And the first part was really boring. Like, as I said, I think I watched the movie and I watched the first season of the TV series. So I kind of know pretty much everything that happens in this book, sort of, because there's a lot of differences. Yes, that's true. But I pretty much know all of the basic key plots. And I don't really enjoy the main characters, like Clary and Jace. I don't really like them. I don't know why. She is just. I know that she's supposed to be 15, 16 in this book, apparently. But she's just so childish and such a spoiled brat, you know? And I don't know. I can't empathize with her character very much. I hope that the rest of the book changes my mind, but I just can't. And Jace is just, I know that he probably is, like, he has this troubled past or whatever, but he's just so full of himself. Like, I could never like a character like that. Like, imagining myself in the main protagonist's shoes, I could never. And I don't know, their relationship is just so strange. Not that we have a lot of it in these 117 pages, but it just is very strange. So, yeah, I don't know. I will just keep reading and hope it gets better, I think. I'm not positive that I can finish this book for the end of the readathon, so probably I would only have 4 owls done. Which I think it's enough to pass, but I'm not sure. I will have to check it again to pass, like with outstanding. But I'm not sure, so I have to go and check it again. I am kind of sad though that I'm not going to be able to read my book for The Fence Against the Dark Arts, which was City of Ashes, so I would have to read this first. And so that means that I can't take the next exam for Defense Against Dark Arts. And I am not even sure that I can finish City of Bones. I'm not seeing that happening. Which means that I won't be able to take Care for Magical Creatures in my next exam readathon. Which is kind of sad because these six are actually the ones that I really wanted to take, all of them. But I have a life and a course to take, and I have to graduate, so I kind of have to focus on that. And I have a job and everything, so yeah. Right now, I think that I'm gonna go to sleep because I'm very tired, and I'm sorry that I haven't been posting with the normal quality, but life is kind of getting in the way of that. Yeah, things are getting complicated, but yeah, so I have this to read. I am not going to read anything today. Well, maybe I'll finish a chapter and then I'll see, because it's already past midnight and I really want to sleep because tomorrow I have to get up early to go to the gym before a reunion in my faculty, like this class about the internships. So yeah, I'm forcing myself to wake up early. So that's gonna be it for this video for Friday, no, for Thursday. We're on Thursday the 26th. Yeah, we are. Tomorrow is Friday. And I still don't know if I'm going to work or not tomorrow because my boss sent me a text saying that they don't know if they need my help or not. So I guess we'll see. If I don't go to work, I'll have more time to read and to study. If I do go to work, I won't have any time to read. So that's that. I don't know. Let's just see how life proceeds. I mean, yeah, so that's gonna be it for today. Bye now. So, update time, everybody. It is now currently 6:30 in the afternoon, and you would say, well, but it is Friday, why aren't you working? And I would say, well, today there wasn't any need for me to go to my part-time job. So I am at home and I am feeling tired as shit. So I just did a little bit of the introduction to my paper for the internship. And
I'm getting fairly tired. So I'm inside my bed, as you can probably see with my pillows, and I decided that I'm kind of having too much thoughts in my head, so I'm going to pick up City of Bones. Yesterday I only read until page 130, so I'm still fairly at the beginning. I decided that I'm going to read this until I get hungry, and then I will go to dinner, and after dinner I will focus more on my internship project because I'm normally more productive at night. So I'm just gonna read, and I will update you with my readings if I read anything convenient and don't fall asleep. I'm sorry, I'm really tired for some reason. But yeah, I'm gonna enjoy the fact that I'm not going to work so I can read a bit and so I can do my studying and my faculty work. So, yeah, I will see you in a bit. So, it's getting dinner time, and I am already on page 200. And right now, we are at the. Oh, spoilers for the City of Bones if you haven't read it yet. But right now, they are going to go search for Magnus Bane because Clary went to the Silent Brothers and they told her that he was the one that had to undo the blocking in her mind. So finally, the freaking action is starting. Like, I pretty much know where everything is going, but finally, it is starting, and finally, we're going to meet Magnus Bane, which is the best character in this series by far. Although, I do enjoy Alec as well, for some reason. And tending to the fact that, spoilers, they're going to be a couple, I can understand why I enjoy them both. But yeah. So I'm gonna go have something to eat, and I don't know, maybe read or watch some stuff while I eat, and then I'm going to work on my internship report because I have to do it and I can't procrastinate any longer. And I've rested, I am feeling better, so I'm just gonna go and grab it because I have to do it. So might as well do it now instead of just pushing it to another day. And it's kind of getting dark. I am more productive when I'm hearing some music at night and just focusing, and no one is distracting me with noises. So I'm just gonna do it, and we will see if it goes well. Oh God, I can't see a thing. Okay, I'm gonna move. Okay, so probably can't see a thing, but I am at my boyfriend's house. The day is almost over, and I'm gonna go meet him at his shop later, just so we can grab a bite to eat and something. So this weekend is just not being the ideal weekend. There's a lot of stuff happening. I am getting very tired of some stuff. But I just wanted to say that tomorrow is the last day of the Owls Readathon. So today it is the 28th, and tomorrow will be the 29th. And I am almost, well, not finishing, but I am on page 315 of City of Bones. So I'm counting on finishing this and still counting it for the Owls, which would mean that I would have finished 5 Owls. And well, I'm still counting it, so we will see. Ah, I need to scratch my eye. It's really, oh God. So yeah, we will see. But I'm really hoping on finishing it. I'm gonna read a little bit more before I go get him, and then I will upload. I will upload. I'm great today. I will update you on if I finish it or not, but I'm really hoping I do. I brought with me also City of Ashes, which is supposed to be my defense against dark arts. Owl, which I haven't started yet, obviously, but I am not sure if I can make it actually. You would say that I have still today and tomorrow to read, And I would say that is accurate, but I also want to be with my boyfriend, obviously. And I have other things to do, like my internship paper and everything like that. So I'm just gonna read a little bit more and then focus on that. And we will see. But I am fairly excited for finishing City of Bones. I know that I can do it. Even if I go to sleep a little bit late, I can finish it because it's like 170 pages left, maybe. I don't know. I don't remember, but it's not that much. This has 500 and God, why is this so 506 pages. So it's not even 200 pages, it's less than 200 pages left. So I can do it today. And that will be another owl for you guys to see. So yeah, and I'm sorry for not updating as much as I should, but I have been working on my internship paper. So yeah, I don't know. Like, yeah, I'm just gonna read a little bit more. Also, I have been playing the new Harry Potter game for the phone. Hogwarts Mystery, I think it is called, and that is freaking awesome. Like, I am loving it. I am currently on level 6, already going to level 7. And if you play that game, just tell me in the comments down below if you do play Hogwarts Mystery, because that shit is really awesome. I am loving it. My character is badass, awesome, and I am doing everything correctly. I am passing all of the spells, all of the potions at first try. I love this. I just hate that I have to count the energy and I can't keep playing as well as I want, but I understand why that's for. Obviously, you can pay to have more energy, but sincerely, I'm going through the game without paying a cent. Like, I want that to have fun and not to have to pay to play. So, you just have to wait some minutes and the gouge will fill. So, it's pretty fine. I love that. If you're playing that, tell me in the comments down below which team you're on and what level you are if you want. I am at level 6 going on 7 and I am obviously a Ravenclaw, everybody. So yeah, I am loving it so far. So yeah, I'm still on year 1, sadly, but I'm already finishing that. So someday when I finish the book. And yeah, that's gonna be all for now and we will see if I'll update you again. We shall see.